May you listen to the graduation message of our student with highest honor, none other than Mr. Vincent Louize Garcia. A round of applause.
Papunta pa lang tayo sa isa. Magnanimous and esteemed guest of honor, that end SDOQC officials, led by our public school district supervisor, Dr. Abuan, school head, Mr. Joey S. Mancha, administrators, teachers, staff, beloved parents, and of course, my co-graduates who successfully solved the puzzles of these trying times, a victorious afternoon. The past couple of years have been the most arduous chapter in the Philippine academy. Aside from the drastic economic recession, the shifting of paradigm in the education sector was also abrupt and very dramatic. It's either we move or we allow this pandemic to hamper learning. And I am glad that we chose the first option. We chose to move and conquer this virus by continuing to learn. Most of the students, teachers, and even parents succumbed to confusion in the first half of the distance learning being the new norm. I myself was also burdened by the consequent webinars that have been conducted just for us to hopefully mend the digital divide. I am used to writing with my pens and papers as a student journalist. I am also used to making my artworks using coloring materials and scissors. And now, we need to learn a whole new setup. It was purely a whirlwind. Naalala ko noon, nag-login ako sa aking cellphone, sa Google Meet, hindi para paano gamitin itong mga Google Suite tools. Pero dahil meron daw reward sa tulong, may parasol, may pachinas daw sa mga bench ni Madam Chinky. After ng webinar, actually, hindi ko rin masyadong naiintindihan. Kasi mahirap na. But I just prayed to the Lord that He will equip me with the wisdom that I need in order for me to conquer my personal virtual crisis, which can also be experienced by you, my fellow graduates. These are not the only dilemmas that try to hurdle our efforts to continue striving for a quality education. Numerous parents lost their jobs, resulting to economic hurdles. Students and teachers even got sick because of the uncertain and unpredictable atmosphere. Students like us needed some decent gadgets for us to conquer this virtual adaptability and virtual mode of learning. But it is very heartwarming and very honoring to be standing here in front of you delivering this message, because that means we did overcome. This feat would not be possible if there are no people who help us out in making the unworkable possible. Our parents, who who did everything in their power, blood, sweat, and tears, just to send us to school. Despite all of the challenges that they too are facing amidst this adversity, our teachers, who did countless group chat follow-ups, multiple home visitations, and unlimited form backlogs, they never backed down and continued to show up during the most difficult times, be it in our academic and even personal pursuits. Even our local government unit here in Quezon City also lent their hand in order for us to beat this pandemic and continue learning. Them giving out chaplets are not just mere financial and physiological help. These are also a testament that our LGU is bestowing towards us an unending trust and hope that we can conquer this new world. And ang pinakamaganda dito, hindi na ibabalik yung tablet. Hindi na yung pinakaregalo sa pera. Diba? Most importantly, my fellow graduates, you need to tap your shoulders for doing a magnificent job. We have all the chances to back down, but we never did. We pursued our dreams and we fostered resilience, though we know the things ahead are still uncertain. And this made me realize that if we do certain things today, our future will not be uncertain. Instead, it will be clearer and brighter. As long as we continue to live and dream, there will always be more exciting parts to look forward to in the future. So the challenge for us at seniors is this. We need to foster resilience and excellence in order for us to arrive safely and sound to the next exciting parts of our life and future. Let us try harder and aim higher. We will become successful because we absolutely can. And by that time, I hope